Good morning to everyone. Today's webinar is on cloud-to-cloud integration with WSO2 ESB connectors. This is the agenda for today's webinar. During this session, we will look on the needs of the integration between heterogeneous applications in modern enterprises, how WSO2 ESB and ESB connectors cater to these requirements, and also we will go through a demo on some use cases. Let me start with a glimpse of modern enterprise. In modern enterprises, most of the organization consists of various systems which may using different protocols, different standards, or built by various vendors. And some systems might even be on the cloud. In order to get a job done, these systems may need to communicate with each other. This can be done with point-to-point integration. But in such case, scaling the system or troubleshooting the systems becomes a nightmare. So the WSO2 ESB eliminate the complexities of point-to-point integration of the organization and integrate all disparate systems with the bus architecture. ESB is designed as the middleware layer that enables interoperability among heterogeneous systems and services using the SOA models. Let's move to the WSO2 ESB connectors. Connectors are the abstraction of third-party APIs which are publicly available. With these connectors, the consumption of APIs on the cloud through ESB just got easier. You can just point and click to the connector wrapper and keep using the operations supported by the APIs. With WSO2 ESB and connectors, you can perform cloud-to-cloud or cloud-to-on-premise integrations. Today, we are mainly focusing on cloud-to-cloud integration. Now, there are 140 plus connectors available in our WSO2 store. WSO2 Developer Studio provides dynamic tooling support for connectors, where you can import the connectors and use their operation in ESB configuration. For today's demo purpose, we are going to use WSO2 Developer Studio 3.8. In our demo, we are going to see two use cases. The first use case is integrating Salesforce with HubSpot, and the second one is integrating Venn with Shopify, MailChimp, and Nexmo. And we are going to see how to deploy these scenarios and test them. I will hand over this to Kirtiha to continue with the demo.
Thanks, Keshavan. As the first use case, we are going to retrieve all contacts from HubSpot and create them as leads in Salesforce. Let's say we are using HubSpot as marketing tool and Salesforce as CRM tool in an organization. We may need to allow activities and information to move seamlessly between these two. With this integration, sales team will consistently have the most up-to-date leads from marketing team. Let's go for the demo. This is the latest version of WSO2 Developer Studio. You can download this as a plugin or whole Eclipse setup from our WSO2 product site. In this dashboard, you can find the projects which are involved with WSO2 products. For our demo purpose, for the creating the integration scenarios, we need to create the ESB configuration project. For that one, I am clicking on ESB config project and creating a new project with the name Salesforce. After to work with the connectors, first I need to import the connectors into Developer Studio. So right click on it and select add or remove connector. Here you can select the connectors from directly from our Storyly, or else if you have already downloaded connectors, you can select them from your local machine. So this takes some time since we have 140 plus connectors. We need time to load these connectors. Here you can find all connectors from our store. So I for our demo I'm selecting HubSpot and Salesforce connector to import them. Now I need to create a proxy service to retrieve the contacts from HubSpot and create them as a leads in Salesforce. So creating a proxy service with lead creation as a custom proxy. After creating the proxy service, you can find the imported connectors and available operations within those connectors in this palette. So for retrieving the contacts from HubSpot, first I need to configure the HubSpot. So I'm using init method here, and I need to give the API URL and API key to configure HubSpot. So I'm giving the API URL for HubSpot and also giving the API key here. So if you want to use the confidential data, you can also use WSO to secure wallet to save these confidential data, and you can mention it here. You can use those here. So now I need to retrieve the contact. So using list contacts method, these are the properties which are optional. You can set it with the list contacts method when you invoke this. After retrieving all contacts from HubSpot, we need to iterate through the response to create them in Salesforce. For that, I am using iterate mediator. So giving an ID for the iteration and also setting the XPath expression here. Now I need to retrieve some fields from the for the lead creation from the response of list contacts method. For that I'm using property mediator to store the details. So I'm getting the last name here, last name of the contact, and setting the expression. So give the XPath expression here to get the last name from the response, and getting another property company. And setting the XPath expression for getting company. Since for a lead creation method, company and last name are the mandatory fields, I am getting those two only here. And now I need to configure the Salesforce. So I am using init method from Salesforce connector and giving the username password and login URL here. This is the login URL for the developer account. Now I need to create a payload for the lead creation method. So I'm using a payload factory mediator. I need to define the format here. So I have already created the format, so I'm using that one. Here I am creating the S objects, and since I'm creating a lead using the type as lead and giving the namespace here, and also define the last name and company within the S object. Sorry. And now I need to set the arguments to get the values from the properties which I have already stored. So adding the expression here, need to get the value from the message context. So I'm using and also I need to get the value from company. Now I have created the payload for lead creation method, so I am using Salesforce create method. For this one, I need to define the S objects here. I have already created it in the payload, so I am getting from there. Now I have done the list context and create method. Once we have done this flow, we need to send the response to the client. So for that, I'm using response mediator here. Sorry. Now you can view the source for this configuration. After completing this one, we need to create a composite application project. For that, in dashboard, I'm clicking on composite application project and creating the composite application project. As Salesforce CEF, and also we need to select the projects for dependencies. Now I need to export this as card project. Yeah, we need to save the configurations and then need to export this as composite application project and giving a destination here and finish. Now we have exported the card project. Now going to the ESP instance here. To work with the connector, first we need to import the connectors in our ESP instance. So I have already added all required connectors here. If you add a new connector, by default the status will be disabled. So after adding a connector, first you need to enable them. Then you can use the methods which are available within the connectors in any ESP configurations. So after that, we need to add the composite application project here by using this option. Here you need to select the car file here. Since I have already added this, I'm using that one. Here I have added that car files here. So if you go to the proxy list, you can find the lead creation proxy here. So I am going to invoke this using SOAP UI with an empty request. So it's, well, since there is only one data in the HubSpot, we have created it in Salesforce. So if you go to Salesforce here, you can find the lead created from HubSpot. Now go to the second use case here. This is the second use case about product marketing. Product marketing is the overall process of conveying a goal, conveying a good or service to customers. It helps to identifying potential marketers for a product and encouraging potential customers to purchase the product. Here we are retrieving the products from when, and if it is tagged as e-marketing, we are going to create them in Shopify as products to sell them, and also getting the product details and create a campaign and send them to the subscribers using MailChimp. And if it's tagged as preferential marketing, we are going to notify the customer about the products. So I have, for this one, I have already created a project. So we have created two sequences. One is create product and market, and do the other one is do preferential marketing. In create product and market, we are creating the product in Shopify. For that, we are creating a payload that needs for the create method and creating the products in Shopify. And also we are getting the subscribers from from MailChimp, and create the campaign payload factory for payload for campaign method, create campaign method, and create a draft campaign in MailChimp and send them to the customers. And the in the other sequence, we are getting the register sales from Shopify. Register sales from Vend, and iterate through the details and get the customer ID from that one, and getting the details for a customers like mobile number and name, and send create a notification here and send it as a message through NextMob. Now we have already created two sequences, and let's see how to use this in the proxy. So I'm creating a new proxy here. With product marketing as and also custom proxy. After that, I need to list get the products from when. So I'm using init method. So we can for the we here I have to configure API URL and access token for when, but if we create a config here, what we can do is after the number of calls, we can use this config rather than configuring init method again with the methods. So I'm creating a config here. and giving the API URL for when and access token here. Now I'm going to use list products method here. If you want to use the created configuration for this method, here you can select it from available configuration which you have already created. And we need to give the we can give the details, we can set the optional parameters for this list products method here. And after getting the products here, we need to iterate through the products. So I'm using iterate mediator here. And giving an iterate ID. And setting the XPath expression to iterate. Here, I need to get the properties from list products. So I'm using property mediators like product name, product description, and ID. So I'm using product property mediator here. Give the name here. And setting the expression here. Setting the expression here. And we need to set the, get the another property, product price. So give the name and like this we need to get other another properties here. And after that I need to I'm going to use switch mediator to select the sequence if that it's the product is tagged as e-marketing. I'm going to call the sequence create product and when create product and market sequence to create a product in Shopify and send the notification to the customer through MailChimp. So I'm using a switch mediator here. Since there are two cases, I'm configuring with two branches and setting the XPath expression here. And regular expressions as e-marketing and preferential marketing. If it's e-marketing, then we need to call the sequence when create and product marketing. So here we need to give the sequence name here. And if it's preferential marketing, we need to call the sequence when do preferential marketing. So giving the sequence name here. Now we have completed this proxy. So you can find the source view here. As we have already done, you need to create a composite application project and export it as a composite application project. So we have already exported it and imported it in the ESP instance. So I'm using that one here. If you see here, we have the product marketing proxy here. So I'm going to invoke this with this try this service. So I'm sending the request here. If you see here, we have sent the we are getting the notification that we have sent the notification to the customers.